Huh? So what do you say we clear the ring and let's settle this with an over-the-top rope battle royal right now?
Yeah.
Hold your horses, Matt Stryker. I think you've all forgotten about the most important part, which is, of course, the Nexus. Now, unfortunately, Darren Young couldn't be with us tonight, but the six of us would love nothing more than to be involved in a battle royal, because, of course, a battle royal gives us an opportunity to be in a match where it's every man for himself. And I promise you at the end of it all, there'll be one winner, and that winner will be the same winner from NXT season one, me, Wade Barrett.
What do you say we make this official? A 20-man over-the-top rope battle royal next on NXT!
Well, I say let's get this party started. Run it!
A 20-man over-the-top rope battle royal, including those six men, the dangerous Nexus. Next.
It's every man for himself.
We are back on NXT, an impromptu 20-man over-the-top rope battle royal. NXT rookies, WWE pros, and the Nexus, every man for himself.
I never thought I'd see this. Let's break it down even further. It's Nexus versus Nexus. Wade Barrett said he was going to win this over-the-top rope battle royal. NXT versus NXT, pros versus pros, every man for himself.
Every man for himself, but for the moment, it seems to be every man against maybe the world's strongest man, Mark Henry. They were surrounding the big man, and well, the Nexus, is that all of them? All members of the Nexus have stepped out of the ring.
Well, they're not eliminated, they didn't go over the top rope.
Remember the rules of the Battle Royal, you've got to go over the top rope with both feet hitting the floor. And to your point, I believe they slid underneath the bottom rope as this Battle Royal continues in the gang up.
There's about 30 guys on Mark Henry.
He's been eliminated. That was real smart to eliminate the big man. And look at the Nexus. Like a pack of dogs, wild hyenas, picking at Mark Henry, who was tossed over the top rope. And that has been the MO of the Nexus all along. Those hit and run attacks. And there goes Henry into the steel post. The Battle Royal continues in the ring. The Nexus continues to we're picking apart Mark Henry outside the ring.
Yeah, Cole, but we got to kind of feel a little silly here. You got to think that the Nexus probably had some sort of plan, some sort of scheme, and you're seeing it unfold even further.
That's Eli Cottonwood who was eliminated, and the Nexus swarming to him. Assaulting Cottonwood outside the ring, again picking their spots.
Like a wave to any superstar that's been eliminated, comes the Nexus, and
what a clothesline! Vicious! The Nexus picking out the weak link, the man who's been eliminated. As Percy Watson may go over the top rope here. And Watson not only worried about being eliminated, but you gotta understand that everyone in the ring is probably witnessing what's going on outside the ring. This is supposed to be every man for himself, but the Nexus have begun to work as a group, a machine outside the ring.
You're trying to avoid getting eliminated, but then you have to realize that when you are eliminated and go over the top rope, that the Nexus is gonna be like a wolf pack and get all over you once you are eliminated, just pummel you.
See the Nexus licking their chops as they wait outside the ring. That was John Morrison barely hanging on. Remember Morrison, the victim of an assault by the Nexus last night in the locker room.
So think about it, Cole. Nonetheless, if you're in the ring,
look at on the other side. On the other side, I believe that's MVP. MVP is in trouble on the far side of the ring, completely circled by the Nexus. And there goes look at John Morrison taking out Sheffield and Barrett.
And Kofi Kingston.
And right back into the ring. So the hit run attack that time by Morrison and Kingston. And now the WWE pros showing solidarity. Things are breaking down in this battle royal on NXT. And we are back on NXT. Ladies and gentlemen, right before we came back from commercial break. And look at the Nexus. Nexus back into the ring. And everything is breaking loose here. The Nexus have never been eliminated from this battle royal, Josh. They just picked their spots.
Well, during the commercial, there was a stalemate between Nexus and the pros and rookies who were in the ring. Nexus on the outside, but it's once again completely broken down.
Yeah, and what happened, ladies and gentlemen, right before we came back from break, those battle lines have been drawn, and Cody Rhodes and a couple of other individuals, I couldn't quite make them out, but they attacked the likes of Kofi Kingston, who were trying to hold off the Nexus, really stabbing him in the back, Benedict Arnolding those men.
Oh, you can never turn your back on anyone with battle royals.
Tossed over the top rope as the Nexus start to dominate, working as a well-oiled unit inside the ring. You see Morrison trying to fight back, Zack Ryder among others. Mike McGillicutty working on Wade Barrett. McGillicutty part of the season two rookies. Look at Zack Ryder go against Gabriel. And for many of these superstars, this is all about survival, ladies and gentlemen. And see, you see Otunga get knocked around pretty good in the corner. This is where Nexus has issues, at least in this matchup, when they're broken away from their fellow, you know, their partners. When they're singled out like Otunga is there by Morrison and McGillicutty.
Nexus is used to working as a cohesive unit, working as a pack, and you can see him grouping together up in the top corner of your screen.
And McGillicuddy's been eliminated. Now Barrett heads toward that corner.
There you go.
And again, the Nexus.
And this is where the Nexus can hide in plain sight in the middle of the ring.
Yeah, they've regrouped. And they understand it is strength in numbers. As the rest of the WWE superstars and rookies go after one another, the Nexus just lying in wait. Don't know how wise that was of Husky Harris to try to go after the Nexus, but again.
And there goes Husky Harris.
All these rookies trying to make a name for themselves here from season two. Kaval eliminated. I believe that all the rookies have been eliminated from this matchup. And the WWE pros that remain are Rhodes and Kingston, The Miz, Morrison, and Zack Ryder.
I believe John Morrison said, hey guys, let's separate, let's restart, let's try to keep our eyes here on the Nexus, as the Nexus have backed themselves into another corner.
Exactly what they're doing here. It's 6-on-5 now. Odds a little bit better for the WWE pros. Morrison taking control.
Come on, I got this, bro. Woo, 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 I got this. Come on.
I don't understand the strategy.
You're nothing.
Trash talking the Nexus.
Come on.
Leave Ryder believe. Look. Miz just eliminated Ryder.
Everybody understand what's going on here. There's four of us now.
Eight. We're outnumbered.
Miz's partner's obviously not too happy with him.
I
helped you throughout season one. I helped you guys get to where you are today.
Huh? You're an idiot, Miz.
Miz trying to train these guys some sort of truce here. What do you say?
What do you say?
What's wrong with them?
Why would you do this?
You're gonna start with them.
What's his strategy working?
Miz, yeah, his strategy. The Miz eliminated himself. The Miz was in full retreat mode because it didn't seem the Nexus had any business making friends.
What did you call Miz earlier, a strategist?
Great strategy there. That was great strategy. Would you hang around?
Nope.
And now it is down to 6-on-3. Rhodes, Morrison, and Kingston against the Nexus. Going right after the Nexus. But again, and Cody Rhodes, look at Rhodes just sitting on a rope, not even wanting to get involved. Slater, Barrett, and Otunga, 3-on-1 on Morrison. It's a 3-on-1 assault on Kingston on the other side.
Is Cody Rhodes looking to pick the right opportunity to get involved or just hang back and watch?
And the Nexus pack dog mentality.
This is the chaos and anarchy that comes with the Nexus.
Cody Rhodes trying to hide, but the Nexus doesn't care. Let him stand over there. This way they can decimate Kingston and Morrison and then turn their attention to Rhodes. And this is where the Nexus is so dangerous. Numbers game again in their favor. The graduates of this very show again leaving their mark, but that time Morrison trying to fight back. John Morrison and Kofi, here they come! But again, Josh, victims of the numbers game.
Nexus just too overwhelming, too much for Kofi Kingston and John Morrison to overcome.
Somewhere John Cena is watching every second of this.
John Cena reliving what happened to him.
Oh, look at Kofi Kingston trying to fight back as well, but I mean, come on, he's one man against three there. Same with Morrison, one man against three, and Rhodes just has no interest in getting involved at any point of this show.
In this battle royal,
oh, look at Morrison, skin of the cat hanging in there. John Morrison hanging into this battle royal just momentarily.
Will John Morrison hang on?
Slater and Otunga.
Both feet have to hit the ground, remember.
Look at Morrison hanging on. Gallant effort by John Morrison. Morrison trying somehow just to grab and hang on those ropes.
John Gabriel Morrison involved. Using knees, feet, hooking that top rope.
And he's eliminated. Again, 4-on-1 numbers got to Morrison. And Kofi Kingston. He's in deep, deep trouble.
That's only a matter of time for Kofi Kingston.
See if Gabriel and Barrett and Sheffield sort of look back.
Oh, this is the right idea by Kofi Kingston. Start throwing.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter. 6-on-1. Kofi just getting beat down here after that last gasp. A pack of wild dogs salivating.
Worse than that, they're making Kofi Kingston think about it.
And finally, Kingston is eliminated. Merciless. Kingston mercifully eliminated. And now it's Cody Rhodes who tried to hide throughout this entire matchup.
Well, will Cody Rhodes take the route of the Miz and eliminate himself, or will Cody be like Kofi Kingston and try to fight off the Nexus?
Come on, man, come on.
All I can say is Cody's going to get everything he deserves.
Cody, you should understand that Nexus has no business making friends. And look at this. Cody Rhodes just getting hammered on in a 6-on-1 assault by the Nexus. And there goes Cody Rhodes tossed out as well. And the Nexus standing tall.
Here is your winner, Nexus.
Well, the Nexus out to destroy everything. Elimination by attrition.
This was never an every man for himself over the top rope battle royal. The Nexus had one goal in mind. Goal accomplished.
The goal may be accomplished, but I don't believe the damage is over.
Come on, guys. Hey, it's over.
And Morrison, look at Morrison still trying to fight back somehow because he realizes what he faces if he's tossed back in that ring. And Sheffield and Tarver.
And the Nexus are involved. It's like you're locked in captivity.
Look it. Kofi Kingston. This will crack ribs. Kingston. Now Cody Rhodes' turn. The Nexus doesn't care who you are, who you align yourself with. They are hell-bent on Bedlam.
Systematically dissecting NXT here tonight are the Nexus.
And Justin Gabriel yet again with one of the most damaging maneuvers that we have witnessed. This 450 splash. Bone crushing by Gabriel. Wade Barrett said earlier tonight the Nexus was going to enjoy this show. Well, in their sick way, I believe they have. Nexus!
Wade Barrett, what's your reaction to what the WWE Universe thinks of the Nexus?
Matt Stryker. Matt Stryker. I've never had a problem with you before, but I'm not so sure that standing in this ring is the smartest thing you've ever done. So if I were you, I'd back up right now before things turn ugly. Ladies and gentlemen, season one of NXT. I've come back today as the Nexus and proved that we can make a difference here in WWE. Regardless of whether we were labeled rookies or not, what we're doing now is something you can't understand because it's part of a much, much bigger picture.
Wade, with all due respect, are you proud of what you did to John Cena on Monday Night Raw?
Matt Stryker, I'm proud of everything I've ever done in this ring. I'm proud of these men who stand beside me as the Nexus. Because one thing's for certain, you're either Nexus or you're against us.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the headline to this story here tonight is the Nexus lays waste to WWE superstars again.
This was after Kofi Kingston was eliminated. The battle royal was over. Nexus continued to dish out punishment, Wolfpack style. And there you see the 450 from Justin Gabriel, the exclamation point.
The Nexus seems primed and ready for Sunday. What havoc will they wreak? One can only imagine what will happen, what the Nexus has in store. Money in the bank.
Nobody can stop us.